bitches, I'm infected. My condition is I'm always in my head. These words are my religion. I'm obsessed, it's by decision. I'ma do this till I'm dead.
We were supposed to go to like a tournament in Chicago, I think, at the time. Got hit, kind of awkwardly hit my wrist into the boards and, you know, broke it. I was pretty bummed out, and obviously it's upsetting when you're not able to play, but, you know, I think that's part of the game somewhat.
And it was way more serious than we had first thought anyway, because it was near the growth plate, and if you worked it too hard or hit it again or something, it could affect the growth of your arm. Once he heard that, he didn't use his arm for, I think it was 12 weeks, wasn't it?
Yeah, I just had, you know, one hand on my stick, top hand, and, you know, stick hand with one hand, trying to shoot on your backhand, I guess. I think whenever you do anything, you know, more, it's gonna get better, so.
I wasn't surprised with him because that's just how he is. His shot jumped another level that year. And that was right after he healed and did all that work with just one hand.
So where is, like, where's the gap between Connor Bedard and everyone else? And I include Canada in all of that. And I mean, Shane Wright's a pretty darn good hockey player and a top prospect. We know that. But where is that gap between Connor Bedard and everybody else on Team Canada?
It's not even close. It's not even close. Like, I mean, I don't want to be that guy, but it is what it is, right? And like, Shane Wright, you know, he's the caddy, and Connor Bedard's playing in the Masters, if you get my drift. I mean, it's just totally different.
Start on this guy because he's so unique. Just such a special tournament. I think it was must-see television for all of us just to see not only the tournament itself, but Bedard. And I look at those clips, Jennifer, and I'm thinking, man, and I know you mentioned off-camera, Ron, about Wayne Gretzky, just that vision and how he sees everything in front of him, and he knows where everybody else should be.
Joshua Wall walks in, and goes to the